In this video, I'm going to show you how to export reports out of QuickBooks into Excel. We will be exporting multiple reports into the same Excel workbook. So to start off, I wanted to show how we are going to set up our Excel file to make it easier to accomplish this. I've opened Excel and you can see that I have just one sheet down here. To add more worksheets, click on the plus button. And you'll see it starts naming them. I want to rename these so that I can find my information easier. To do that, you highlight the sheet name, you right click, choose rename, and now that it's highlighted, you can type the name you want to give this one and hit enter. I'll do this one also. Right click, rename, and I'm going to call this one week 2. Enter. Now I'm going to save this so that I'll have it ready to use with my QuickBooks. So I'm going to go to File, Save As. And I choose to save this in my documents. And I am going to call it, instead of Book 1, I want to call it QuickBooks Payroll Reports. And I will save this. I'm going to go ahead and close Excel. And I'm going to go over to my QuickBooks. And I have my company open. So I'm going to go to Reports, Employees and Payroll, and I'm going to choose Payroll Summary. I'm going to change my dates so I'll get the correct data. And it's going to be from 10/1/15 to 10/07/2015. So for the first week of October, I've brought up the information for my employees' paychecks. Now I'm going to click on Excel and say Update Existing Worksheet. I'm going to use that worksheet that I've created. The first time I'm going to need to browse, and it defaulted to my documents, and here is the one that I set up, QuickBooks Payroll Reports. So I'll click Open. And now it asked me to select a sheet. So if you recall, I renamed some of the sheets and they show up here. So we're going to put this one in week 1 and click export. Say yes to this message. And we'll see that it is working on getting this data over to Excel. And when that is done, Excel is going to open for me. And here we have it. Okay. Here's the name of my file, and here is, in week 1, the information I just sent. Now, let's save this and close it again. And I'm going to use this same report, but I'm going to change the dates now so I can show you how to send a second one over. So, we're going to have the week 2 is going to be from October 8th. To October 15th. You see we have that information. We go to Excel, Update Existing Worksheet. Now it has defaulted. Okay, but we're going to say make sure we have it there because we couldn't quite see it all. I am going to select a sheet, Week 2, and Export. Again, say yes to this message, and we'll wait for Excel to open. And to speed the process a little bit, I'm going to go ahead and click down here when it starts flashing. And here we see now week 2, I have my October 8th through 15th information. Going back week 1, I have October 1 through 7. I'm going to save that. And close it and recognize that we could go ahead and we could continue adding more weeks of this payroll summary to that same Excel sheet if we chose to. For those of you that may be experienced users, there are some shortcuts to what I did, but this was hopefully helpful to those that are not experienced users.